This is the view from our porch in Hiram, Kentucky. It's, I think, the last day of August in the year 2020. There's much troubles in this time. We have this virus. We have an upcoming presidential election. We have people upset, tired. Angry. We have people upset that they're old issues that are not really better than they were. We have laws and regulations and practices so that things appear better. But what's in the hearts of men and women, young people and old people, is not necessarily better just because the laws are better and because people are hiding what's still deep in their hearts. We need to understand what can change hearts and what doesn't change hearts. And we need to remember, please, people, when you're frustrated and angry, and believe me, I get that way myself. My grandfather on my father's side was Irish. And my grandmother was German. And on my mother's side, English. Both sides all the way back, as far as I know. But even that one quarter Irish that I have, or no, I thought, oh my, what if I had more Irish than what I have? I'd be in trouble big time. But just ask my wife, I get angry. I get angry. But I've learned that if I just stuff it, if I just squash it down, it doesn't really help. I have to be careful. Sure, I don't want to hurt anyone. I don't. And if I let that stuff build up, there's these chemicals associated with it. The scientists have found out that cortisol and all kind of bad stuff that just really does physically eat me up if I let it. I have to get it out. Burn up those, they say it's a sort of a burning up process. Cortisol needs real physical activity. I gotta wave my arms around. So I says, you're waving your arms around again. I said, I gotta wave my arms around. Oh, goodness. Well, now you see the leaves are falling. This maple tree, sometimes maple trees get really beautiful in the fall. This one never has. It looks like the leaves get some bit of a blight. A spotty brown. And then they fall. But that's okay. And the sound of the highway is loud this morning. But that's okay. I'm hopeful that means we've got some real, I don't know, commerce going on. People are going places and doing things. And goodness, I hope they're being careful, because this virus, man. it is real. And yeah, there's been all kinds of hype, and it's been used every which way that it can be used. People with agendas. But please, people, do what we've got to do. And don't just wear a mask because you've got to wear a mask. Because somebody told you you have to wear a mask or you can't go in the store. Oh, goodness. They've pushed this thing about how wearing a mask protects other people because you might have it and not even know it. You might be asymptomatic. And that's true. But it also protects you, people. It does. I don't know. They don't want to tell us that. They're still afraid that people will hoard up the N95 masks that the nurses and the doctors need. I guess they're still afraid of that. I don't know. Maybe they're afraid that they won't. But if we use masks really well and wash our hands frequently, keep social, they might be afraid that we won't need a vaccine. They want to sell the vaccine. They want to make money with the vaccine. And if we wear a mask and it does protect ourselves, we may not need it. They won't make the money. You know, there's that old theory, you know, follow the money, figure out who's going to make money, and you might figure out why people are doing what they're doing. And let me tell you, some of these people are smart people. They're sly. They know how to put words together so it looks like something that it's not. They know how to put a paragraph together in a sentence and use the right kind of words so it sounds like they're all compassionate. And all they really want to do, they're trying to lead us down the road to where we will do what they want us to do. Finest food. Yeah. No, I'm not kidding. I wish I was. You know, there's a Bible verse, and I believe it's one of those in red letters. It says that the poor will always be with you. Well, I believe that it's also true that the really, really wealthy will always be with you also. And that's greed, isn't it? And that's the love of money. The love of money, that's the root of all evil. I don't know that that's quite true. I think that's a really good indicator that there's some evil going on there. If you see people saying things and doing things that you're able to discern is really about money, that's a pretty good indication that there's something pretty close to the root of all evil. But people, you know, we have choices. We do have a few important choices that each of us can make. And I like to think about this. I don't know why I like to think about this so much, but I do. Because it's been important for me. I realized at one point in my life that I had a choice as to whether I was going to keep God out of my life or allow him into my life. And I decided I didn't want to live without it. That right there, I think it's really the heart of my testimony. Things happened in my life so that it was made really, really obvious that I had that decision and I could make that. And so I can tell about that. Because I do know something about that. You can go through your life. I realized a while back that there's a really pretty well-known quote. I love quotes. They summarize things. They put in just a few words something meaningful. It's beautiful. Oh, gosh. You can go through your life believing that either nothing is a miracle or you can go through your life believing everything is a miracle. And I tell you, if you look up quotes on that topic, you're going to find people from all walks of life. And even different religions have had something to say about that. And even people without religion at all, maybe. Scientists have had something to say about that. Powerful motorcycle come to this part of the country to enjoy the beauty of this area among the roads, the nice windy roads over the mountain. Yep. People are looking for beauty and enjoyment. There's something about sitting here and watching the breeze cause the leaves on this maple tree to dance, and some of them to fall off. It's just gorgeous. We can still, we're blessed, we are blessed. That we can still step out in this beautiful land of ours and look and listen and smell and feel and walk and swing. let's take care of it, people. Let's take care of this land and all the life that is in it. And maybe you have to start with yourself. Take good care of yourself. And then take care of those that are close to you, that you know, that you love. And then start looking around and you'll find out you love everybody. Those people over there, they're not enemies, they're neighbors. They may not know it. And you may just be finding out yourself that they're neighbors. But, oh, goodness, people. Have a good day.